Iranian nurses, victims of COVID-19 and destructive policies. As Iran's COVID-19 crisis continued to escalate and many Iranians died every day, Iranian regime Supreme Leader Ali Khamenei banned the purchase of globally approved vaccines on January 6.
ورود واکسن آمریکایی و انگلیسی به کشور ممنوعه. این من به مسئولین هم گفتم، الان هم به طور عموم میگم.
Although the regime has vaccinated a very limited number of people, medical staff and in particular Iranian nurses as high-risk groups have been victims of the regime's inhumane policy over the past 14 months. On April 15, the state-run Resalat Daily wrote, "The miserable conditions of Iranian nurses, and the delay in vaccinating this group of medical staff is undeniable. They have no strength left. Iranian nurses have reached the point of exhaustion and desperation." So far, the regime has not provided accurate statistics on the vaccination of Iranian nurses and medical staff across the country. In other countries, a lot of vaccines and other facilities are freely provided to medical staff to strengthen them in the COVID response. But in Iran, not only do nurses not have enough equipment, but the regime is even charging the medical staff for vaccination. On April 7, Karvakargar website quoted Mohammad Reza Sharifi Magadam, the Secretary General of the Nursing House, as saying, "There are about 170,000 to 180,000 nurses in the country, many of whom have contracted the virus. There are more than 400,000 medical staff in the country." Over the past year, the regime has not allocated sufficient funds to provide the necessary equipment and vaccines to prevent medical staff from contracting COVID-19. According to the Secretary General of the Nursing House, so far, the minimum COVID-19 death toll of Iranian nurses has been about 130, which is the highest number in the world compared to the population of Iranian nurses. Serial suicides among medical staff have leaked to the state-run media. On May 5, Jahani Sanat quoted Sharifi Magadam as saying, "In recent days, a number of nurses and medical assistants have chosen voluntary death, means suicide. In just 1 week, three of the best medical assistants have chosen to end their own lives. Iranian nurses barely make ends meet, so experts blame low income for choosing such deaths." The Deputy Minister of Education of the Medical Council organization considered poverty as the reason for suicide of a number of assistants in specialized fields and said, "This group is one of the underserved and hardworking segments of the medical community, and the residency period is one of the most difficult periods in the life of a doctor in Iran. Because this group is facing various problems, including education, economy, and livelihood at the same time. They have very low income, less than 40 million rials per month, and usually, at this age, some assistants have a family, and they are responsible for their spouses and children." Ilna, May 12. In the past 14 months since the outbreak of COVID-19, due to the poor living conditions and the collapse of the economy, a large number of Iranian nurses have been forced to migrate. Armin Zarian, the chairman of the board of directors of the Tehran Nursing Organization, told the ISNA news agency on March 30, "Since the beginning of the COVID-19 pandemic, about 500 nurses have migrated from Iran every month to countries such as Canada, Sweden and some Arab countries in the Persian Gulf."